So today I've come into London. It's the first day of the expanded ULED zone, but I haven't come in for that reason. I've come to look at some new Tesla Superchargers which have just opened, and these are generating a lot of interest on social media, and I've come to show you why. So somewhere up here is a Tesla service center.
In 50 yards at the roundabout, continue straight.
Oh, hang on, no, we can't go in there.
In 100 yards at the roundabout, right, continue straight.
It's a good start. Where is it?
Exit the roundabout onto Glover Drive, then turn right. Take the next right.
Right, I'm sure the map is wrong. It's saying I need to go into Tesco's. Surely I don't.
In 150 yards at the roundabout,
this is fenced. Surely I don't go into Tesco's. Well, this is a good start. I can't find it. Let's have a look. Where the hell am I going? Oh, there's a Tesla there, so maybe I am on track. What a weird place. Right, going straight over here. Oh yeah, what a weird place.
In 150 yards you will arrive at your destination.
So just up here on the right is the,
you have arrived
there, that's where I want to go. That's the Tesla service center at Tottenham, and there's the new superchargers. Not sure if I came the right way to get into here, but anyway, I'm here now. Wow, this is quite a service center. This place is huge. Right, that one's marked off as coming soon. Let's pull up on that end one there. So, what's the big deal about the superchargers? Well, these are the new Tesla version 4 chargers, and these are the first ones to be installed in the UK. But they're also the first ones in the world to have a contactless payment screen here as well. And there are 12 of these units here, and these are open to all vehicles, not just Teslas, even though it's within a Tesla service center here. So I'm in the Ioniq here, so let's see whether I can charge. And I'm not going to use the app. So what it's saying is plug in to charge, 50 pence per kilowatt hour. We'll use the Tesla app. So we've got a CCS connector there. That also goes in fine, by the way, with a big enough gap there, which was an issue on some of the other ones. And it's still saying plug in to charge, tap to pay. So let's get my credit card. That's now authorizing. Says approved and charging in progress. So there we go. So obviously the Hyundai Ioniq in 38 kilowatt hour form, as I've got, is one of the slower DC rapid charging cars. These have a peak charging rate of about 46 kilowatts, something like that. So obviously I'm not going to be testing the power of this unit. I believe these are 350 kilowatt or so. Well, I think the units themselves can deliver up to 600 kilowatt, but obviously it depends on the site, the installation and the grid connection and that sort of thing. So I believe most of them are either configured as 250 kilowatt or 350 kilowatt. I don't know what these are, but of course I'm never going to be pulling anywhere near that, so I just can't test the maximum charge rate. At the moment we are pulling 32 kilowatt and we've put half a kilowatt hour in so far in just a few seconds, of course. So I apologise for the background noise, it's incredibly noisy here. We're right on the edge of a dual carriageway over there. I guess that's the North Circular, and also got this inner road here as well, so it's very noisy here. So there's 12 units here. That one on the end isn't ready yet, these have only just opened, but today there's only myself charging here. There was a chap there who's just pulled away, and there's a Model Y over there. But apparently I read on social media today before I left that all the Tesla supercharging network right across the UK and Europe is free of charge today. I don't know why, I couldn't see the reason, but everything's free. So that's why I thought I'll come and visit this site today, because I'd get a free charge while I was here and it would pay for the journey. But by the looks of it, it looks like I'm getting charged. I am, look, £1 already. And I thought this place is going to be busy. I thought, well, if it's free electricity, everyone's going to be flocking to a supercharger site, particularly like this, where it's open to any vehicle. But maybe it's not free today, or maybe this isn't free because it's the new version 4s and it's the other sites which are going to be free. Or maybe at the end of this charging I don't actually get charged, we'll see. So what makes these Tesla version 4 superchargers different from the previous generations? Well, as you can see, they look very different, but the key thing is they have got much longer charge cables, and that is because they're designed for any electric vehicle. So with Teslas, as you probably know, the charge ports are always in the same place. They're on the back of the car, exactly the same place as the Ioniq here. So when you pull up to a charger, you only need a pretty short cable to reach your car. But if you pull up with another car, let's say a Jaguar I-Pace, the charge port is on the other side. And when you pull up to a traditional Tesla supercharger in one of these other vehicles where they've got a charge port in a different location, you have to park in the wrong bay to make the cable reach, and then you hog two charging bays. But with these new version 4s, they have put in apparently a 3 meter cable, so it's now long enough for all vehicles. To be honest, that doesn't look as long as other manufacturers are putting on their chargers, but I guess Tesla have worked this out and it is going to be suitable, but they still don't look particularly long. But apparently that's 3 meters, is it? I guess it is, yeah. But the previous generations had 1.8 meter cables, which were rather short. Okay for Teslas, of course, but pretty useless for most other EVs. So these new version 4s is the new Tesla standard in terms of superchargers, and these are going to be rolling out in all new sites, and maybe they will upgrade existing ones, I don't know. But anyway, when you see these version 4 superchargers, it's likely that that site will be open to any vehicle, because these are more suitable for any electric vehicle. And that's now why they've also got the contactless payment terminal within the units here, because any vehicle can charge on it. You don't need the Tesla app, you can stop and start the charge with your debit or credit card, just like you can with any other UK rapid charger. So I've just been in and used the toilets, and they've got the normal Tesla lounge with a coffee machine and Jaffa cakes and all that sort of stuff, and a little showroom there which has got a Model X Plaid, a Model 3 and two Model Ys. And at the front there, they've got a whole suite of AC destination chargers as well. Though opening up a supercharger network to all electric vehicles like this within a Tesla site is just a great marketing tool for Tesla, because while you're charging your vehicle, you're likely to go in there and use the loos at least, but you can spend your time browsing around the showroom looking at the Tesla products. They've got a power wall in there, they've got all the merchandise, and they've got a selection of cars you can look at. So it's a great way of spending your half an hour or so, and obviously a great marketing tool for Tesla. And obviously, being not a traditional dealership, there's no pressurized selling. There are two people that are working in there, but they just help you with any questions if you've got it about their products. You don't buy from here, you go online to buy your car if that's what you want to do. So a much better experience going in there than walking into any traditional dealership showroom. I've just noticed actually this end one, which isn't currently working, is actually a disabled bay. Look at the wide bay there, it's great to see. And then they've got a sign up here to say this is a priority charging bay for disabled, elderly, pregnant women or babies in prams. There we go. It's good to see. So I'm still charging. It's currently added 19 kilowatt hours of energy, charging at 37 kilowatts, and it's cost £9 so far. So one thing that will be interesting is if you can get a receipt for this transaction when you've dabbed your credit card there. So I've purposely used my company credit card, which is the same card I've got registered to my Tesla account. So it'd be interesting to see is whether that transaction for this charging is going to appear in my Tesla account and therefore I can get a receipt. But I purposely didn't use the app for this reason, to test this and to see how you get a receipt if you're just a non-Tesla customer without using the app and you're just using your card. So maybe do you email them like you do with some of the other networks? For the majority of people, it's not going to be an issue because the majority of people don't necessarily need a receipt. It's only if you're doing business miles and you need that VAT receipt. So that's one other thing I'm going to look at later on, is whether this transaction has been applied to my account because I've used the same card, and that's purposely why I didn't use the app. They've actually got an Ioniq 5 there pulling in to use the chargers as well now. This chap in the Ioniq 5 is at 42%. He's just plugged in. So we'll just see what charging rate he's getting. And it's at 42 kilowatt at the moment. And after 1 minute, it's not ramping up. It's still only at 42 kilowatt. This is also a good example of pulling into the wrong bay as well, because he should have really been using that charger and pulling the cable round. But because he's used this one nearest to his charge port, it's left this bay unusable. But of course it doesn't really matter today. There's a three other Teslas pulled in there, but still there's another four units empty anyway. But after 2 minutes, it's still only charging at 42 kilowatt. So obviously not very good for Ioniq 5. These have got incredible charging rates on these cars. So he's just down there checking with the others to see whether it's this unit. Apparently that Model Y there is charging at 160 kilowatt, so maybe he's going to move and see if he gets anything different, because he's still only getting 42 kilowatt on this one. So I'm at 83%, so I'm going to disconnect now. Right, this actually stopped charging at the same time, because obviously I reached a threshold in the car, and I've been charged £11, delivered 23 kilowatt hour. And there we go, there's a receipt. You got a
you get a receipt?
Yeah, you get a QR code there for a receipt.
Okay.
Let's do that. Let's just get my camera.
And I'll send it to them and say you didn't it should be free today.
There, didn't do it in time. That's annoying, it's now gone. So that's what you've got to do to get a receipt, but you've got to be quick. Anyway, I'll see if I can see that in my account, or maybe I'll have to speak to Tesla about that and see if I can get a receipt, because that's something that obviously many drivers are going to need. Wow, the background noise here is unbelievable. It's just such a pleasure to get in the car and be isolated from that road noise. So that's it for me. I've got a charge to 80 odd percent there. So yeah, it doesn't look like it was free. This chap here also came here because he was expecting it to be free. It looks like he's a taxi and he sort of knows all the places around to get the cheapest energy. And at 50p a kilowatt hour, he's very pleased because that's much cheaper than most. But he did say there's a 50 kilowatt one locally at 36p, but there's often a queue and there's only one unit. But for him, these are sort of 20p cheaper than other networks, so that's a huge saving when he's running as a taxi, and he says he charges every 2 days. Anyway, I'm going to get off now, so that will do for this video. If you found it useful, as always, please do click the thumbs up button on YouTube. That really does help. If you want to know more videos about the UK charging infrastructure and have a look at other videos I've made on other charging locations, then I'll put a link to a playlist in the video description below, and I'll see you on the next video.